That may not make much sense, but it's the only way I can put it into words.
Started about 2 months ago. Every time I answered the phone, I'd hear it. The first one was just a loud beeping noise. Now they're mostly these creaking, howling sounds.
You don't like this?
Well, once it was a man talking really fast.
What'd he say?
I couldn't make it out. Some foreign language.
Do you have a line check?
I even had our number changed. But before I got a chance to give it out to anyone, the call started again.
It's not a question of believing them. Like I said, they're honest people.
How long have you lived here?
My whole life. I grew up right over that hill.
A farm?
Shucks, no. Real life house. Indoor plumbing and everything.
Sorry.
We even had shoes for church and school on this side.
Where the hell are you?
I'm still here.
Yeah, she is. Turn the fan off, please.
Something's come up.
You're kidding. Something of national interest in West Virginia?
No. Scientific. I'll tell you about it later.
Something else, Your Highness.
Okay?
Wasn't that a little bit
cold
to you?
Obviously not. It's okay. I have a cardigan next to me.
Congratulations.
We're parked up here and sort of making out in the back seat.
What did the doctor say?
He couldn't explain it.
See this one here? It ain't never healed.
We're getting engaged.
Hello?
Thank you. about it.
Okay.
I gotta talk to you. Last night I woke up with the worst headache I've ever had in my life, and I went into the bathroom to get some aspirin, and I happened to look in the mirror, and I swear to God, I see something I can't describe, but it sure as hell I love my reflection. And then I hear this weird howl coming out of the sink. And there's a voice. It's a voice. And it's saying, do not be afraid. 99 will die. 10 for 9. I wrote it down. It just keeps saying the same thing over and over for an hour. And then it stops. When I wake up this morning, I look at this piece of paper where I wrote down the words. This thing was on it. I did not draw that.
Scan is clean, Gordon. No sign of any physical problem.
Are you sure? Because Miss May's wife had a tumor.
What you had, Gordon, was a first-class migraine. I can write you a prescription if you like.
Yeah, that'd be good. Thank you, Doctor.
There were other symptoms, though. He had hallucinations, heard voices. Are they both associated with glioblastoma?
I see nothing here to suggest something as exotic as glioblastoma, Mr. Klein. But if you'd like, I can refer Mr. Swomo to another neurologist for a second opinion.
He's wrong.
No, that'd be fine. Thank you. Thank you very much. Gordon!
I'm hallucinating. I'm hearing voices. Was your wife hearing voices before she had her tumor? No.
Number 9 out of Denver has crashed. A representative of that airline is expected to make a statement at the airport shortly. Now, there is no confirmation, but all 99 passengers and crew members are believed dead.
That you have on the entities you call.
Were you contacted? Are you pretending to have a professional interest?
Yeah, no. No, I'm a reporter for the Washington Post.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Fine. I don't work in those areas anymore.
I don't understand.
I was trying to swim, but I was too cold, and I kept looking for something to hang on to, and there were presents floating all around me. They were wrapped up, they were tied with bows, and I tried to grab onto them, but they kept popping away. And then I started to sink, like a stone. There was nothing I could do, I was falling. But it felt good. I was letting go. I was letting myself go, and all I could see was black, and all I could feel was the darkness above me and the lights coming from below. And I knew I was dying. And then I heard this voice, like somebody whispering in my ear, "Wake up, number 37.
Told me about that plane crash.
You met him?
Yeah.